Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss the topic on refugees. You may be knowing refugees are the persons, or they are the displaced persons from one country and who were being forced to cross the national boundaries. What for the fear of persecution from their native country, and who cannot return back to their country. So when there are religious, ethnic or tribal violences, differences, then even during the times of war, they cross the borders of their country and come to the other countries, and they are called refugees. So yesterday I told you about migrants. Migrants are the persons who go from one place to other place, number one, for a compulsory, so since they are compelled, since they do not have enough money to equip their family or to better their standards of living. In both these conditions, migrants normally will move from one place to the other, that too within the country, but refugees normally they cross the country. Very recently we have seen so many instances of the Syrian refugees coming in boats, dying in the middle, and even tears came down from our eyes on seeing the dead body of a Syrian migrant boy left on the beach of a sea, right? So these are the precarious conditions of the refugees we discussed in total. And now India, of course, our culture itself is normally we sympathize with other people, and even though he's an enemy, if he comes and surrender to us, we'll give protection to him. Therefore, even though there is a protocol, that is convention and protocol on the status of refugees, 1951, India did not become a member because of the hurdles of refoulement and other things. I will tell it later. Normally, we give shelter to all the people. Also, we also suffered during 1972 Indo-Ugandan conflict. The peoples of Indian Indic origin, they were literally driven away by the then president of Uganda, Idi Amin, and so many people come back to India, and they have become refugees when they went to other countries. Even during the partition also, when India and Pakistan divided, many people wanted to go to Pakistan, come back here, and once again they have got the rethinking, but since the time frame has been fixed, they could not go back, and some people through some other routes, they came and settled, they are the refugees. Likewise, Sri Lankan Tamilians, so there was an ethnic war between Sri Lankan Tamilians and Sri Lankans right from 1983 to 2009, and actually it has given birth to LTTE, Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam, Prabhakaran, you may be knowing, and it caused the death of late Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi also. You may be knowing all these things. They are also refugees from Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan refugees. Likewise, refugees from other countries are also there, but normally now we have to accept the case of Rohingyas and also the Chekmas, as well as Hizangs from Bangladesh and also Myanmar countries. And of course, the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019, it has given a leverage that the government of India will give citizenship. Please remember, the refugees, India is governed by the so-called Citizenship Act 1955, and also the Constitution, Articles 5 to 11, discuss about the status of giving citizenship to a person. Please remember, in India, normally we do not go by the nationality. By ours is by jus sanguinis, that is citizenship by descent. If your father is an Indian, you will get Indian citizenship. Your grandfather, yes, you will get. But not by jus soil. Jus soil you have to provide. That is by right of birth. Yesterday we discussed the case of Sesi Kumar alias Sesi versus state of Tamil Nadu, where he claimed that he was born in Trichy Government Hospital. Of course, Supreme Court has taken into consideration, but normally the government may or may not take into consideration, because once you are born in India, you can become a citizen by birth, because your decency should be there. But reverse is the case with USA. Suppose when a person is born in America, he is called as American born citizen, even though he is an Indian. But even though his roots are Indian, but he will be called as American born citizen, right? So as regards the refugees, we have to think about the National Register of Citizens also. It has case said Sarbananda Sonowal case we discussed in 2005. In that case, we discussed IMDIA Act also, right? We have all discussed. Now let us go to the rights of the so-called human rights of refugees. Six rights are there. They are more important. Number one, right to protection against refoulement. This is refoulement means. Normally, a refugee comes from Syria to India, for example. You cannot send him back. You cannot return him back to Syria. Why he has fled away from Syria? Because of the persecution. Persecution ante vemmadabadi tarunkovadam. Champestha, champestha ani bayapadam. That is persecution. So if he gets back to Syria, what happens? He will be persecuted. He will be killed. And what is the object of his coming to India? So let him remain. So refoulement is that one. That is, don't return him to his country, and that is a right to him according to this Article 1A, Clause 2 of the Convention and Protocol on the Status of the Refugees. Second, right to seek asylum. Actually, 1A Clause 2 comes for asylum. Asylum will come in international law. Please remember, asylum means Sharanarthi enter. And political asylum equestar. Political asylum there ki, if he the party in power, suppose somebody rebels against the party in power of a country, normally he tries to go out of the country and seek asylum in another country. So best example is Julian Assange of WikiLeaks. So he was staying in the embassy of Ecuador in London as he got a political asylum like that. So many. So this is a right. This right is mentioned in ICCPR also. Then right to equality and non-discrimination. Normally we follow this, and even for refugees also. Right to equality, Article 14, and non-discrimination, Article 15. You have to remember. Then right to life and personal security, Article 21. Time and again, we have been telling about Article 21. The state should protect the life and the personal liberty of each and every individual. Here, the personal liberty is taken as a personal security. Then, these two things are most important. Fifth and sixth, right to return. That means, if the conditions are satisfactory, if the conditions come to normalcy in his country, yes, if he wants to go back, he has to be allowed. He has got a right to return. You cannot force him to stay back here. Suppose a refugee comes and works in your coffee plantation or tea plantation for cheaper rate, then the conditions are there in his country are normal. He wants to get back, but you cannot ask him to stay back. Right? Next, six, right to remain. This is another thing. Suppose even though the condition is good there in his native country, suppose if he wants to, of course, he wants to settle in our country, yes, he has got a right. Right to remain. Both rights are there. So these six rights are important. Human rights, of course, once you get only a simple question of 4 marks in this aspect. Now, let us discuss a decided case law. This case law is R versus Secretary from the Home Department, 1987. This happened in United Kingdom, right? So, in this case, what happened is Mr. Shivakumaran and five other Tamilians, actually, they are Sri Lankans, we have to call them as Sri Lankans. They left Sri Lanka for the fear of persecution because they were Sri Lankan Tamils. So, in order to avoid the persecution by the original Sri Lankans, they left Ceylon and came to United Kingdom. But they don't want to go back to Ceylon for fear of persecution. If they go back, definitely they will be killed like Prabhakaran of LTTE. That anyway, that fear is there. So they have applied to the Secretary for the Home Department of United Kingdom for political asylum. But the Secretary disagreed. He has dismissed their petition. He stated that there is no absolute necessity for them to seek political asylum in United Kingdom because the Sri Lankan government is not going to persecute them. That is his inquiry. Right? So, since they are not satisfied with the order of the Secretary Home Department, they have filed a petition, they have filed a writ petition literally before the Honorable Supreme Court of United Kingdom. right? The Supreme Court has, of course, they have dealt with so many topics, so many objects, so many concepts in this manner. But of course, the judgment stated that the test should consider whether there is evidence of a real and substantial danger of persecution. If they are able to prove substantially that there is fear of persecution, yes, they will be given political asylum. But anyway, it is an administrative order. It is a political thing. Therefore, normally, the courts will not interfere in such matters. They will have a review whether the officers acted according to the rule of law or not. That's all. But here, what happened is, the writ petition was not allowed because even though they applied under Article 1A, sub Article 2 of the Convention and Protocol on the Status of Refugees for the Political Asylum, but the Home Secretary has got information that no persecution is expected in Sri Lanka even though they return. That means they do not have threat to their lives. It is not that dangerous. So therefore, the opinion of the Secretary is upheld and his application is dismissed. Of course, this is a negative example. Anyway, definitely human rights are there for the refugees. We have been seeing Sri Lanka, Tamilians, they have been stating about 1 lakh people. They are staying in Tamil Nadu state, particularly in Chennai, Coimbatore, Madurai, Trichy. Yesterday I told you that Sishi, he was born in Trichy Government Hospital. They are there. Likewise, Burmese, they have actually, the Burmese refugees, of course, before initial stage of our independence, there were repatriates from Burma also. For that purpose, in Ongole, if see, near the traffic police station, even traffic police is also in that area. So, near traffic, Burma colony is there, still it is there. Right on the side of this spinning mill Chirala, there is a colony called as a Sri Lankan colony. These people, they were called repatriates from that place. Normally, they used to swim in the sea from Mannargudi area, and they used to come to Tamil Nadu near Dindivanam, Vidurum part some village district. They used to come and settle there. So they become refugees. Slowly, they are getting citizenship. Now, as far as Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 is concerned, of course, it's a controversial. Some people appreciate it, some people deprecate it. It's a different thing. But anyway, Government of India has agreed to give citizenship to people belonging to, I think, 6 religions, like Hindu, Buddhist, Sikhs, the Christians, Parsis, except Jains, except Muslims. The reason is Muslims are the forward company. Half which countries of Afghanistan, Pakistan and Bangladesh. People who are having the persecution theory or a fear, they can jolly well, already they migrated, they are refugees of India, they are staying in Assam, Nagaland, Manipur, in so many places. So the cutoff date is fixed as 2014 is cutoff date has been given. So if anybody comes before that date, definitely they will be treated as the citizens of India. So no refugees. So this is the good action taken by the Government of India. Of course, there are controversies why India, the Muslims are left over. So government says Muslims are the dominant community, major community there. They will not be persecuted. Of course, this is one theory. Whether it's a political issue, whether it is there or not, but Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 allows the refugees who are settled in our states, definitely they will also get that citizenship. Likewise, 25/3/1971, that date, that is Indo-Bangladesh war. So who came prior to that date from Bangladesh, they will also be given citizenship. The NRC is only for that purpose, National Register of Citizens, and IMADA Act, actually Illegal Migrants Detection Tribunal Act 2005, it has been deleted only Foreigners Act 1946, there is, that's why foreign tribunals are existing in the state of Manipur and Assam. NRC, if anybody has got grounds against the NRC, if his name is not found as a citizen, then he can approach the Foreigners Tribunal. Right, so this is all regarding the refugees. I think I have not given in the notes. Better you once again go through the video so that you can be thorough with the refugees. Thank you very much.